Hi, I'm Seth Rotenberger, and today I am going to utilize the BIM Navigator to replace a component in an assembly with a BIM part. BIM, or Building Information Modeling, is a great way to combine architecture, engineering, and construction in NX. I'm going to start off by replacing this second building with a different component. I've already created this component and saved it where all the other files are at. I load the part, and as you can see, there's nothing there. That's because when we head over to the part, it's only a reference drawing. I'm going to head into Application and head into the BIM Design Navigator. I can now add levels to the part. Using the line tool, I can just sketch out a couple lines for the different levels that I want. Doesn't matter how long they are, just so that they are parallel to the floor. The first line is positioned on top of the foundation reference line. The height of the other levels can be initially approximated and constrained. I have a couple of dimensions already prepared that I would like to have between these floors. Using a dimensional constraint, we will define the height of the first floor as 159 inches. A second dimension will be used to position the top of the building to be 390 inches. NX is now going to generate the three individual levels that I have created. This is going to show up in the BIM Design Navigator, as you can see. The elevation box needs to be resized so that it occupies the same size as my reference image. This reference box is the container that all parts of my building will occupy. To create the walls we need, I first need to make a sketch of the perimeter. To do this, I use Sketch on Level and select the first floor. The size of the foundation for this building has been defined in the reference drawing. We will sketch a rectangle to match the foundation dimensions. The size of the foundation will be parametrically controlled using two sketch dimensions. 570 inches on one, and 983 for the other side. I can now create the walls of my building using that sketch that I just created. I select level 3, which is the top of level 2, and the walls are created. I make sure that the interior alignment is selected so that the walls go inside the sketch. If I head back into the power plant assembly, everything we have already created has updated in the power plant. I am now going to make level 2 the work part and use grid to create some reference geometry. Grid lines indicate key positions within the building. In this example, we are creating some grid lines that represent the position of the walls within the building. The outside grid lines represent the extents of the foundation, and the interior grid lines represent the center lines of the interior walls. The outside lines need to be just inside the outer wall, and to do this, I can easily grab and move the corner lines into the position that I want. I make certain to do this for both corners. At this point, the exact position of the interior walls are not defined. NX enables you to approximate the position and then later return to the sketch and explicitly define the wall locations. Again, using the wall command, I select parts of the grid lines to make my interior walls. Making sure that the levels selected are 2 and 3 will ensure that the walls only go from the second floor to the third floor. You can see how quick and easy it is to make a building using the BIM Navigator. Looking in the power plant assembly, we can clearly see that these interior walls have also been updated to reflect our changes. If a change is needed in a building, it is easy to do so in the BIM Navigator. Let's change some wall dimensions. To do this, I head back into Grid and simply grab and pull a line. And when NX updates, the walls do too. If we'd like to change the height of the levels at any time, we can head back into the level command. Equipment on the ground floor requires more clearance with the ceiling. The required floor height is now 450 inches. As you can see, it is easy to edit the level heights from the BIM Design Navigator. Looking in the power plant assembly, we can see that these changes have also been updated with the model. I would like a roof to finish off this building. To do this, I select the roof command and use our earlier sketch as a reference, making sure to select level 3. You can see how easy it was to make a building using BIM. You saw me create levels of varying heights, and then make a sketch on the bottommost one. You saw me build walls referencing this sketch, and I then made interior walls using grid lines. I was then able to modify all these things and have the model update in the power plant assembly. Finally, you saw me finish up the building by adding a roof. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.